Welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to have a look at a practical job posting that I found on one of the freelancing sites. So this is the crux of the task that needs to be performed. So reading keywords from Excel and searching those keywords on a particular page and scraping all the results. So in this video, we are going to talk about how you can read keywords from Excel file in a Scrapy Spider. So the example that I have created is this site Stack Overflow. And as you can see that here is the search box. And if you search something, if you put something in square brackets, it is a tag. So just notice the URL right now. The URL is having Scrapy as the last parameter. And if I change it to Java, the URL will become Java and you will have all the questions tagged with Java. So what I have done is I've created two files. So this is the Excel file. I've created some hypothetical columns, but this column, column number B. So this is actually having valid tags. So what we have to do is we will read these tags from this Excel file and we will see how we can do it in Scrapy. And similarly, I have created the same file in CSV format. So first, let's talk about CSV. Now, there are multiple ways you can read CSV. Probably the first solution that you would think about is importing the CSV module, which is actually inbuilt. And you may want to use this. But what I would advise is using Pandas. Now, Pandas library is actually very powerful, but we will be using a very small functionality from this. And this functionality is a simple function, read CSV. So we have read CSV and read Excel. So let's start with read a CSV. So all it needs is a name of the CSV file. So that's it. That's all it needs to get the content of the CSV file. And this is going to return one data frame object. Let's print it and let's see what's the output. So run it. And here you can see the output. So there is priority, tags, users, all the three columns and the indexes. So what we want to get from this result is only the tags column. So for this, all we need to do is we need to call like that. But note that it is case sensitive, so it should be capital T. So let's run it once more. And now you can see that we have only the first column and there is no column heading, only values, but we also have the row numbers. So what we can do is we can simply call the values, this attribute. This will give us the values. And now if I print it, it will be an array. In most of the cases, what you would want to do is you may want to call this toList function. So now if we run it, so let's run it. So now we can see that we have a nice list with all the values from that particular column. And we can do exactly the same thing for Excel file. The only change will be instead of read CSV, it's going to be read Excel. And similarly, we will be passing the XLSX. So let me comment this out and let's run this one and we have exactly the same result. So as you can see, using Pandas, it is really, really easy. Just in two lines, you can get the results. And what you can do now is probably wrap them in a function. So we can call it read CSV, put it inside this function. And instead of printing it, let's use the return statement. Similarly, let's put these inside a read Excel. So now what we can do is we can create our spider, Scrapy Gen Spider, and let's call it Stack Overflow and fourth parameter for start URL. Just going to put X. So the first thing that we will do is we are going to delete allowed domains and start URLs. And we are going to use the start request function. So this is where we will actually create the request URL that we need to pass. So let's take this URL from here. Let's create this as, let's call it base URL. And if you notice, the only thing that will change here is the last part. So I'm going to use curly braces here. So what we will do now is, from this file, we are going to import these two functions. So right now they are very small, so we can just copy paste, but instead let's do something what you will do in practical scenarios. Now this file is read files. So let's go to our spider and from read files, import read CSV and read Excel. These functions are going to return a list of tags. So let's run a loop. So for tag in read CSV, and remember that this is a function call, and now we are going to yield scrapy.request and base URL.format tag. So what it will do, it will create a new request for all the items which are in the Excel files. And if you do not provide a callback, the default callback is parse. So there is no change required there. And now just to make sure that our code is running correctly, let's go to the page. Let's print this number. So this is going to be more exciting. And I'm just going to right click and copy XPath. So this is the XPath. So what we are going to do is we are going to yield the number of questions. So let's call it questions and response.xpath and this xpath, and I'm also calling the text and then get. One more thing that we will yield is the tag name, or let's print out the URL. So response.url. So I'm not going into much details because our objective is just to learn how we can read CSV in Scrapy. And let's run this spider, scrapy run spider, so.py, and directly sending the output to, let's say, this is CSV, so CSV output. And now we can create a JSON file or a CSV file, anything that we want. Let's create CSV for the sake of simplicity. So very quickly, we can see that 36 tags have been processed and 36 items have been scrapped. So we can see that we have the data. There is a lot of blank space, so this we can take care very easily. So I'm going to delete this file. I'm going to simply surround this expression with normalize space, opening bracket and closing. So this should take care. And one more thing that we saw is it returns like this. So let's strip this part also. So once we have this, bad spelling, so let's correct it. Questions. So I can do it in the same line, but let's do it separately. And I know that this is in the last, so let's do it like this. And comma. Ready to run. Clear the old output. Run it again. So very quickly, the run is complete. And if you look at this, we have everything, and this is not stripped. Why? Because I did not assign it, stupid mistake. But anyway, I'm not going to run it just to correct this mistake. This time let's call a read Excel function. Let's run it again. We will just change the file name to Excel output. So quickly we have the file, and as you can see, we have all the results, the number of questions, as well as the URL. So it's a very simple example, but it is going to help a lot in a lot of projects. So good luck and see you in the next one.